The next morning, we headed south out of Davos and couldn't quite believe what we'd stumbled on. Mile after mile of deserted perfection.
Harry in the combat mode for the Wasp attack. Killed two of them. A third is king his.
Even Jeremy had to concede.
But
I was right about Switzerland.
This is absolute heaven! Oh, this is much more like it!
This road was a test of brakes, steering,
run away, baby,
and handling. An ideal place then to reflect on the cars we'd brought on our motoring holiday.
Everything about this car now has come alive. It's suddenly in its element.
I wonder how much more of this I have to endure before I can admit that this is a terrible car and that I hate it and I want to go home.
There is actually a physical pleasurable sensation that runs up your arm when you turn the wheel. It's uncanny. Tony Clarkson today married a Lamborghini and moved to Switzerland.
And then it hit me. I was in a Lamborghini in the Alps.
All I need is a pair of sunglasses and some Matt Munro.
Questi giorni quando viene il bel sole.
Oh no, hang on a minute. We'd all pretty much decided that we'd found driving heaven. Well, two of us had. But then, after we popped over the border and back into Italy, we found a cherry for the top of our cake. The Stelvio Pass. 15 miles of asphalt spaghetti draped on an Alp. It was stunning.
Should we do it?
What an experience. thank you, thank you, thank you.
We finished our run, and as the cars ticked themselves cool, we knew their work was done. Our quest was at an end. Davos to Stelvio, the greatest driving road in the world.
Going on holiday next year, forget Centre Parks, just go there.
Yes, now, the cars. So, James.
No.